How could you be trusted? Does your business perform the way that you're working so hard for? Is your business engaging and appealing a large number of fans? You know, most of the businesses, your competitor as well, have a marketing that simply shouts and tells to people how good they are, how cool their product or services are, and hoping to get leads and sales as a consequence of this. You're a business owner, yes, but you're a customer as well, so I just want to ask you a simple question. Imagine if you were walking down the road and you suddenly meet an unknown person that stops you and starts telling you that they are good, that they offer a good product or service, would you actually stop, listen, and make purchase from them? You wouldn't. You probably wouldn't, would you? Because you simply don't know this person, because you simply were doing different things and then you suddenly get stopped by someone that you don't know, and that simply doesn't even show you anything. They simply tell you that they are good and they do expect you to trust them and to buy from them. Maybe I'm sure that it will be even someone stopping and buying, because, you know, never say never, but wouldn't you feel more comfortable or confident in buying from someone that you actually know and that as a consequence you trust? So, bearing this in mind, if we now move to the online digital marketing world, your ideal customer would be the person walking down the road, while your business would be this unknown person that stopped the customer because they have something to offer. So, even in this case, if you don't have anything to prove, if you don't share anything with the customer and you simply have a marketing that is saying, I have something good to offer, we are good, our product or service is very good, well, probably it's not gonna be working. This customer doesn't know your business, so most likely, as you in the preview example, wouldn't buy, most likely from an unknown person that stopped you down the road, your ideal customer is not gonna make any purchase from you, because you can tell them whatever you want, but if you don't share with them anything, if you don't show them that you're actually good for real, well, you can say whatever you want, but it's hard to believe, isn't it? People buy from companies that they trust. People buy because they have problems to solve in that specific time, and they need a product or a service to solve that problem. So that most likely they are going to buy from companies that make them feel comfortable in making the decision of buying the solution of their problems from them. So, how could you make your ideal customer to trust you, to fully trust you? So, what you need to do first of all is to work on your image, setting up yourself as the best professional that is going to make people's life easy. So, how do you do it? The way you do it is by sharing your values and your beliefs, sharing advices with people, with your audience, so that they are going to understand, they are going to feel that you're actually good in what you're doing, and they're gonna be feeling more comfortable and more confident in deciding to solving their problems by actually buying from you. I want to make an easy example. So, I often get contacted by people offering me this incredible opportunity of making a huge amount of money with apparently the minimum effort, sharing with me the most incredible opportunity. So, they don't say anything more than what I just said. But, of course, I don't feel like I want to close any door straight away, and I get a little bit interested, because you never say never, and Why not? A huge amount of money with minimum effort. Why not? So I ask for more information. And the only thing that I get in return is basically them keeping telling me the same. Huge amount of money, great possibility, minimum effort. And they don't share anything else with me. So I don't feel like they are sharing any values. I don't feel like I'm learning anything more than simply these three sentences. So I don't feel like I can trust them, would you? And so in the end, what I end up is not to make any purchase from them, is not to get this offer. And yes, at this point, I close the door. It's by sharing your values and by sharing advice that you make your audience understand that you are a competent figure in the industry. It's by sharing with them your beliefs and your values that you're gonna make people comfortable with your business and with the future choice of making a purchase from you. Studies show that people are most likely to buy when they feel like they are learning actually something than when they simply get told to buy. So if you don't share anything, you simply remain there telling to people simply that you're good, that your product or services are good, keeping hoping that someone at some point stops and listens and make purchases from you, buy from you. You don't want to beg for new clients, simply hoping that someone at some point is gonna buy from you. So let's be the ones that actually give the chance to your audience to learn something. Let's be the ones that share values and beliefs and advice and make people understand that you're the good one, that you're good for real, that you're the one that they need to solve their issues. So that's the thing. Make it more about your customer. Think about how you can make their life easier with your knowledge and with your product or services. And there, share values, share beliefs, share advices with them. The more you give, the more you get to people. And the more you get to people, the more they're gonna feel comfortable in choosing your business when they need to solve their problems, so that you can increase exponentially your leads and consequently your sales. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Comment below if you have any questions or if you would like me to speak about any specific topic. So once again, thank you for watching and see you the next time.